Hey everybody, so today I'm going to be doing a wear test on the new Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin 24 Hour Foundation. I have two shades which look so much different on camera now that I'm seeing them that will hopefully work for us today. Packaging itself is a squeeze tube. It's like matte up here and like a glossy see-through shine finish. It doesn't seem frosted right here, which is nice. If you are not following me on IG, you did not see it, but I made a recent like IG story poll about what foundations you guys would want to see reviewed next. So I asked if you guys wanted to check this out, and over 80% of you guys wanted me to review this, as well as some other things like the Beauty Blender foundation, which BT Dubs is sold out in my shade, or our shades, or any shade that has a yellow undertone is sold out right now. Only yellow undertones are sold out right now. And I also, you know, didn't want to review it, you know, just in case you guys don't want to see it, but it seems like my viewer base wants me to touch base on that foundation regardless. But I'm just telling you guys, that's on hold right now. Yeah, you should follow me on IG if you don't, so you can be, you know, involved in what videos are coming out on this channel. And if you aren't subscribed to this channel, you should hit the subscribe button and become part of our fam, because I nicknamed our fam bam finally. This foundation comes in 40 shades. Makeup Forever has always killed the game as far as how many foundations they release. They were, you know, with the HD liquid foundation, like at 40 shades or 40 plus shades since then. So I expect nothing less from them. And they provided this awesome photo with dry and wet swatches for each shade, which was helpful. Hopefully, depending on if this matches. Sometimes those pictures can be even more confusing, but I'd rather have them than not. First shade is Y345, aka Natural Beige, because, you know, Natural Beige rule right there. And the other shade, which is Warm Beige, which is the next yellow after that. So as far as my, you know, shade comparisons down below go, I have different shades for each of the Makeup Forever foundations, because sometimes they don't fully, you know, sync up right, like, especially the Makeup Forever stick foundation, which I love, the HD stick. I don't have it to show you guys because it expired and I threw it away, so that was the right thing to do. This foundation is thick. There is no running whatsoever. It is more of a, you know, cream foundation than a liquid. You get one fluid ounce for $38. In the instructions online, it does say, you know, to use it with the primer, use it with the powder. They didn't release new ones, but they did say to use a step one primer. The only step one primer I have right now is the smoothing primer. I don't have like the mattifying one or anything like that. That one doesn't really work well for me. So we'll see how this one goes on half of our face. I think I'm gonna put on this side because this side has a little dry patch and he needs the most love. The scars are, you know, they're living. They're just hanging out, but I have like a little dry flake going on right there. So we don't want that to come out. I think because this one is not the mattifying one, it's not gonna give me as much problems. I'm gonna just pat it in because it's gonna ball up on me. Oh, it's balling up already. I just moisturized, so it is like freshly moisturized skin. This is why I just don't mess with the step one primers. People say you have to mix it in with a moisturizer and that still gives me issues, so I've now moved down to this dish because I can't remember which shade is on top now. A mess. We're gonna give Natural Beige a chance to shine. I'm so scared that I don't have a match. See, that's Warm Beige and it's even lighter. They dry darker though. I'm gonna tell myself that they dry darker. It's not too bad, right? That's not bad at all. I'll go this side. I really do look very similar, but I think I'm gonna go with Natural Beige just because I feel like it has a little bit more yellow into it. So it's gonna keep going with that. Let's talk about the deets a little bit. So the skin types that it is recommended for is normal, combo, and oily, because the finish is matte. That is what it says on Sephora. It says it doesn't cake, flake, or fade, and it has a breathable full coverage that is a non-cakey matte that blends and breathes with your skin for up to 24 hours and gives you appearance of small pores and zero shine. Doing a great job concealing all of my redness. Probably shouldn't have brought it that high up just in case it's too drying for the under eyes, but it will. Trying to work really fast because you can see that blending it back to where we first applied stuff can be a little tough. Oh crap, I have a huge line on my nose. I 100% don't recommend this with a brush. I say stick with the sponge because the moisture from the wet sponge helps blend it, because it's so dry that it sets super fast, and then the brushes are just like gonna, it's gonna be a muddy mess, just trust me, muddy mess. The consistency is too thick to start spreading this with a brush unless you're working really fast. And honestly, my arms aren't that in shape to be blending at the speed of light. So, oh man, when you get to the forehead, it really throws you off with your shade selection, because your forehead's just so, you know, dark compared to the rest of your body naturally. I still think we look pretty good, like, with the rest of my body. Try to spot conceal over the additional redness I have. Okay, I can already tell the primer's coming through because I got this one little tiny flake on this cheek, while this side that had a tiny flake prior as well don't got it no more. So this is probably the maddest foundation I've worn in a while. It's like Fenty matte, if that makes sense, if not a little more than that. And I have been going for a little bit less than that lately. Even though I do have oily skin, my nose looks real dry right now. But we know it's gonna grease up in a little bit, so we should be okay. Mainly on this side, I can definitely see it. And I don't wanna keep layering more, because eventually, it to me, it's gonna get cakey. Because it's apparent that I'm wearing foundation right now on my face. I can see it. It's like a powder finish. As you can see, there's really no shine in the light. It looks like I have a mattifying primer spread across my skin, and I just have nicer skin than I really do, which is totally a lie. There isn't any SPF, so I do not see any sort of flashback issues in the photo test. So I'm gonna finish up my makeup. I don't think I'm gonna add any additional powder aside from obviously my cheek products. And we'll see how this bad boy lasts throughout the day. I'll see you guys in the next clip, aka a bunch of hours from now. Hello. So we are back. It is almost 8:30 at night right now, and we had an early start to the day, luckily. So we've been wearing our face for about 11 hours, and now we're gonna talk about it. What's the tea? So I brought y'all in, turned down the lighting quite a bit so you guys can really see what's going on. As you can see, the nose is undefeated when it comes to breaking up foundations. I did not do any excess powder aside from, you know, highlighting my nose. I didn't even contour my nose today, so generally I probably shouldn't have highlighted it. But as you can see, the nose bridge looks pretty good aside from being oily, snatched wise. But yes, aside from just a little loose powder for that reason, that's all the love that that area got. But of course, my under eye got some loose powder too. And even with that said, it's very oily in this area. I would also like to note that it's been this oily since about 8 hours. It's been cooking. It's been cooking an egg for a little bit. Aside from that, I'm not sure if you guys can see this. This has nothing to do with foundation. If you see these yellow dots right here, I took a juice shot earlier, like healthy lemon shot. It has like yellow stains on my lips now. So that's that. That's not my camera being funky. That's just that. I feel very cakey right here. Like my mustachey area and my chin looks very heavy and built up on that area. For the most part, everything else, like cheek and forehead wise, look really good. My forehead's not actually that oily. My nose is just extremely oily in comparison right now. Like, my forehead itself still feels matte to the touch, which is nice. My under eyes look a little drier than usual. I am wearing the new Too Faced concealer that I did a video on, and it just looks a little drier, so maybe pulling the foundation that high was a bad idea. I probably wouldn't do that if I did wear this foundation again, because it's probably, like, the formulas together is just creating a different finish. But yeah, just the center of my face is looking, this area, I had to make this ugly face as I say it, is real cakey. Really, really cakey. So something about when the oils mix in, your natural oils, it just doesn't go that well. But everything else is okay. So with that being repeated, not really sure how I feel right now. I think shade wise this matched very well. It didn't oxidize. It matched my body continuously throughout the day. I'm not sure if the camera's picking it up as well, but it is like a perfect match to the eye. So for my twinsies, natural beige is our winner. Winna winna chicken dinner. I don't understand why the shade after that was so much lighter. I would expect it to be at least a little darker. So that was a little, doesn't really go a long way. An average amount is needed because it dries so fast. That's something I don't really like about it, is that it's something you have to consciously work fast and make sure, you know, you blend out before it sets because of the finish. So with the matte foundation, that tends to happen more times than not. It's a very thick foundation, as you guys saw. It doesn't run whatsoever. So I don't feel like it feels lightweight or breathable, as they claimed. I don't think it feels breathable whatsoever. I'm very conscious that my face feels heavy right now, so it's definitely not that. Does it give you appearance of small pores and zero shine? Small pores, yes. Zero shine within 7 hours. Otherwise, when it comes to oil controlling, I don't think this is anything to be praised. Take that how you will. I personally don't feel like I needed this foundation in my life. After trying so many others, this is not like a top three contender for me. It says it doesn't cake, it doesn't fade, and it doesn't flake. I will have to disagree. I think it does cake, and I think it does fade. It doesn't flake. Even with my dry patch here that is unprimed, it is not flaking. But my nose is definitely fading, and it's definitely cake. So I'm gonna have to call on some of them claims. Nah, not happening. So with that being said, I'm not gonna give it my stamp of approval. I feel really bad. I know a lot of people want me to approve this, but honestly, truly, I like their other foundations better. So I don't think you need to run out and get this unless you feel like you're missing something like this in your life. Maybe you want a heavier finish. The primer seems to have kept the dry patch on this side at bay, so the primer did work. The prime side does look a little better, but not just overall, generally. Like, it didn't keep anything from fading, more so than not. It just hid that dry spot a lot better. So there you have it. Those are my thoughts on the new Make Up Forever Matte Velvet Skin 24 Hour Foundation. Let me know if you guys are gonna be picking this up. I know you guys are waiting for the Beauty Blender review, and follow me on social media to know when I actually end up ordering it and when it arrives. I need to go find that white towel that I used, you know, for the Tarte Shape Tape foundation video, because we're gonna need that one this time around again. The full-on, like, bed sheet. How the CC cream and the extra matte primer from Arborian work, so that's coming up next. Subscribe if you haven't yet. Thank you guys as always for watching and requesting. Please come rate and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video. Oh, that was a bad idea.